Despite falling to Gen G in the LCK finals over the weekend, T1 and Faker have managed to secure a spot at MSI after months of targeted DDoS attacks that destroyed their ability to properly practice. It's a bittersweet victory that they're going to MSI, but a victory nonetheless. So the other week, we watched as T1 got 3-0 swept by Hanwha Live Esports in the LCK playoffs. Suddenly, the reigning world champions' chances of qualifying for MSI looked in serious jeopardy as they were knocked down to the lower bracket. In the post-game interview, Faker described how the constant DDoS attacks had made it very difficult for the team to practice, creating a situation that was unfair. Some people seemed to get the wrong end of the stick though, and felt like Faker was disrespecting Hanwha Live's victory over T1. And Faker ended up apologizing a few days later for what he felt was a lack of courtesy on his part. Now, some people felt that was needed, others didn't, but let's just talk about the games. In the lower bracket, T1 bounced back against DK in a somewhat scrappy 3-0 that saw more than its fair share of individual mistakes, as well as moments of sheer brilliance.
Zayas now looking for that flank himself. Kellen taking 50% down as Faker, he's going to get himself out of there. It should be the Drake, a possibility, the security for Ona, and they deny the soul. And now, can they actually win the fight as well as everyone's in the Thunderdome? Lucid is going to try and kick away the Azir. The Equalizer just not doing quite as much as it wants to do, and he's stuck inside the pit with nowhere to go. And DK, they're now going to get flanked by Faker. He finds two with the Emperor's Divide, and that is going to be that. That will be the 3-0 as welcome back, T1.
And then came the lower bracket final rematch against Hanwha Live Esports. It had only been 9 days since the two teams had last played each other, but it looked like a whole different T1.
There's the Elder now as they have the executed second finds him in a three-match job from Faker is massive!
And that wasn't the only series-defining dragon fight, thanks to Zeus going completely sicko mode with Vayne Top.
They're the ones with the control.
Whoa!
He's gonna find this Zeri. She is able to press that cleanse splash button, try and get himself out of there, but it's Delight that falls to flank angle from Zeus to Flash. The tumble and the Vayne is going to find the fight. He goes invisible.
With those victories, T1 had done it. They'd gone from getting absolutely dunked on and banished the lower bracket after having their practice ruined by DDoSers to qualifying for MSI as one of the top two teams. The other was Gen G, who they'd now face in the final. Faker's 16th LCK final, no less. And it's important to note here what an absolute cultural phenomenon this T1 versus Gen G matchup has become in the LCK. Every single one of the last 5 LCK finals has been between T1 and Gen G. T1 took the first, and Gen G took the rest. In fact, you'd have to go back to summer 2021 to see a different team feature in the finals. It's quite simply a modern classic at this point. And if you still weren't sure about that, the opening ceremony made it very clear.
Crazy, bro!
Despite Faker doing Faker things in Game 1 to pull off a Quadra as he died, Gen G took Game 1. Game 2 and 3 went T1's way though. Owner Xin Zhao made everyone wonder why it wasn't played more often, and T1's bot lane never really broke into a sweat, putting the team on series point against Gen G. Game 4 marked 100 times that Faker and Chovy had faced each other in the mid lane as professionals. Chovy's Aurelion Sol and Canyon's Karzix wreaked havoc on T1, completely neutralizing owner Xin in what would end up being the shortest game of the series. And so we entered Game 5, the first time we'd seen a Game 5 in an LCK Finals for 6 years, and the fans were hungry for it. And with everything on the line in this final battle, Gen G scraped ahead after some knife's edge team fighting and ballsy corky packages from Chovy that carved T1 open to finally give them the win.
One last attempt, one last package. He's gonna try to send it. Owner with the Crescent Guard keeps it alive. Zeus desperately trying to stop this one from ending as the GA is going to be utilized. He goes in and annihilates them underneath the tech nexus, and that will do it. Gen G will take the 3-2 victory. They will win in Silver Screams.
Gen G's victory makes them the only team in the 12-year history of Tier 1 Korean League of Legends to win four straight splits in a row, with Chovy being the only individual player to ever four-peat. Bear in mind that 2 years ago, he didn't have any titles at all. Just incredible stuff. I've seen some people describing him as the Faker of the LCK, which I love that. It's brilliant. And somehow a compliment to both Chovy and Faker. Finals MVP Keane now holds the frankly bizarre distinction of finishing in every possible position in the LCK standings at least once. That just needed to be mentioned. The series attracted a peak viewership of 2.6 million viewers, making it the most watched league event of the year so far, the sixth most watched league event ever, as well as the most watched non-world best of five in history. Everyone's appetite for League, for T1, for Gen G, and their generational rivalry really feels like it's stronger than ever. For Faker and T1, this will feel like a bittersweet defeat. A few weeks ago, after getting comfortably beaten by Hanwha Life, they would have bitten your hand off for a spot at MSI. They'd just been 3-0'd, their scrims were getting DDoSed, they were falling behind the meta as a result, they even had to stop playing solo queue. But after they were finally able to scrim properly, T1 looked much more like their old selves and pulled off two comfortable playoff victories to go to MSI. Sure, they lost to Gen G for the fourth year in a row, which is in itself an LCK record, but given the horrendous few months T1 has had, they have to take their blessings where they can. So, MSI starts in a little over 2 weeks. Will Chovy become the Faker of international tournaments? His first step will be to lead Gen G to an MSI victory, the first in his or his team's history. And while their domestic victory means they'll be seeded straight into the bracket stage, T1 will have to fight their way to get there through the play-ins, which isn't ideal, but I'm sure they prefer to face NA's second seed than any more DDoSers. North Americans say sheer. I don't know if they say sheer, do they? That sounds like a Peter Drury word, isn't it? Oh, that is wonderful, sheer, brilliant.
Is it English or?
Maybe. I swear you'll never see anything like this.